yeah, let's get it, y'all. Showtime. Time to go out there and win, fellas.
Yo, what's going down, everybody? It is Straight Outta Boston here, aka the King of Boston, and today back to episode 49 of the Tragic Bronson My Career. And today is going to be the last regular season episode of this series. We're going to be getting into the playoffs next episode. I'm going to be doing the same format, except slightly different this year. Instead of playing the first game in every elimination game, I'm just going to be playing elimination games. Just to kind of speed things up, because MLB 13 is coming soon, and I want to get the series done with so we can move on to that game, because it's not that I'm getting tired of this series, but I definitely think it's time to move on from it. It's been pretty diluted. I mean, 49 episodes of my career, especially when I kind of usually provide you guys with just straight gameplay. I don't have all these storylines going on. I'm just not that creative. I mean, I'd love to, you know, if I had time to put those type of things into my videos, I would love to. But, I'm pressed for time a lot, and, you know, if I want to get two of these out a week, it's hard for me to do so, but I'll continue to try and kind of develop my story-making skills and stuff as we go into future series. My MLB 13 The Show Road to the Show series will be pretty good, I think. It's a good series, I think. it's going to be. I think there's a lot of room for creativity in it as well. But anyway, for those of you who are fans of my MLB 12 The Show Athletics franchise series, I think I finally figured out that game. I think I finally got it to work. So look for an episode probably tomorrow, because today I'm going to be posting my AL Central podcast. So I'll have time for it. So I'd rather post two videos today and two videos tomorrow than three videos today and one tomorrow, just to spread things out. So be on the lookout for that tomorrow. And let's get into this gameplay. So we're going up against the Memphis Grizzlies, one of the best teams in the West in this series. And you can see we're breaking ankles. We're going to pull up for two, and we get this one to go. Actually, I think we were battling the Grizzlies for a playoff spot at this point. So they're a very talented team, obviously, but they hadn't. Their record doesn't really show that. I think the only difference to their starting lineup is they had Wayne Ellington starting instead of Tony Allen, because I don't think Tony Allen's on the team anymore. But anyway, 12-12 now, 14-14. Buttinger is going to give us the ball on the break. We're going to pull up for two, cash out. We get that one to go, 16-14. Now Bronson running off the screens. He's going to end up throwing up this three. Straight cash, homie. Haven't heard that one in a while. Haven't been talking about the gameplay in my career videos recently. So anyway, running around screens once again. I put it up. Straight cash, homie. I really had my shot working today. I used Brandon Knight's shot this game, which was shot or released 3, base 32. That's a very good shot for me. I'm really good with it. So I was really hitting my shots today. But anyway, we get the assist on the nice pick and roll to Amari Stoudemire. Amari Stoudemire, man, he's been all right. You know, we've struggled as a team ever since we acquired him, but he's been very fun to play with. He gets me a lot of easy assists. He's performing much better than David Lee did, but I don't know what it is. You know, why we just struggled with him on the team. But a nice pick and roll there to Andrew Bogut. We get another assist right there. And that's pretty much going to wrap up this half. So as you're going to see, Jared Bayless dribbles the ball up. He's going to take a half-court shot. It is going to not go in. And we are going to get right into this halftime report. So I will be right back.
By 9. 53. And we'll be back right after halftime for the start of the third quarter. We'll see you in a bit. And now, brought to you by Sprint.
Great to have you with us this Thursday night of NBA action. Memphis on top against Golden State. They've been very focused on the defensive end, generating steals, showing a high-level activity and aggression defensively. Rudy Gay has simply been taking over against the Warriors. Consistent shooting from the field, making well over 65% of his shots. Not a lot of guys put up a half a basketball like that. And for Golden State, they've been battling. They're really going hard at it on the boards, offensively chasing down every miss they can. A terrific first half for Insanity. He's up to 14 points so far. He's done a great job playing lockdown D.
All right, so we are back with the start of the second half. And this is a pretty short My Career video. I don't know what it was, but there just wasn't that much gameplay. My stats weren't really down this game. I think there were still pretty good stats, but look at the nice fadeaway three right there. Straight cash, homie, as usual. But, you know, I don't know what it was, though, but this is only 9 or 10 minutes, I believe. But usually my My Career video is like 10, 12. Also, I added something at the end, too, so I'll mention that in a sec. But anyway, 20 points, 4 rebounds, 4 assists. We're driving by Wayne Ellington. We're going to get the nice right-hand layup to go. That finger roll. 22 points now on 69% shooting. We're getting double teamed by CJ Jack wide open. He's going to give it back. No, he's not. He's going to take the pull up mid range. What am I talking about? What you talking about, Willis? Anyway, so we get our fifth assist of the game. 60-54, though. We're trying to close in on this Grizzlies lead. We're getting the screen from Amari. We're going to take it to the hole and one. That is right. Getting the and one as they called the goaltending on Wayne Ellington, but I think it went in already. But anyway, we're getting the ball. I see Jared Jack cut into the basket after the double team made Jackson get the layup to go. So we cut the lead to 7. Now it's 70-59, though. The Grizzlies are starting to pull away. We need something big. I'm running off some screens. I catch the ball at the 3-point line. I throw it up. Straight cash, homie. You know how it is. 70-62 now. We got 28 points on 11-15 shooting. What a good day so far for Tragic Bronson. I'm calling for a screen here from Bogut. I'm going around. What am I going to do? I'm going to drive into the lane for the dunk. Oh, look at that. The dunk on top of, I believe that was like Marc Gasol and a few other Grizzlies right there. But we're throwing the three up. Straight cash, homie. So we're really trying to get our team back in it. But we got subbed out and we got subbed back in. And we're down 14 at this point. Now we're down 74-92. So we're down by 18 points. I'm trying to do everything I can. Cash out. Get the mid-range to go right there. 92-76. 94-76, though. Bronson driving into the lane. He stops. He's waiting for a man to cut. Finds Bogut under the basket. That's an easy assist right there. Thank you, Mr. Bogut. 35.6 rebounds, 7 dimes so far on the day. But it's 96-78. We need something. We need to get something going. I'm going to take the fadeaway. 3 straight cash, homie. Look at that shot looking like Kobe or MJ or... You know, one of those guys always says those crazy fadeaways. But now, driving into the lane, we get double teamed. I pull up anyway, cash out. Look at that shot right there. That was, man, double teamed. Feeling like Kobe Bryant on that one. Now, getting the ball top of the key. Straight cash, homie. I'm doing everything I can to get my team back in this game. I cut the lead to 10, I believe. But now it's 104-86. We're down by 18. We just could not get the defensive stops we needed. Amari back to us for 3. Straight cash, homie. So I'm doing everything I can. I got 46 points, 9 rebounds, and 7 assists at this point. They're double-teaming me. I see Jerichak cutting. He's going to get me another assist right there. But time is winding down. We're likely not going to be able to make this comeback. 46 points, 9 rebounds, 8 assists. I find a cutting Chase Budinger who's going to end up putting this one in with the reverse lay-in. And we get our 9th assist of the game. But that is pretty much where it would all end for us. As you see, we're going to get a few last points here. Again, the tough layup when we were double-teamed. We end up with 48 points, 9 rebounds, and 9 assists. You see, I'm going to foul here, and I was trying to get the ball back, and I'm going to I'm going to get subbed out, as you can see. So, that is going to wrap up this video. I thank you guys for watching. Hope you did enjoy. Final score was, final stats were 48 points, 9 rebounds, 9 assists. Solid game from us. Too bad the team didn't do as well. But anyway, it's going to wrap this video, so I thank you guys for watching. Hope you did enjoy, and as always, I'm out. Peace.
Big well in the building.
You came away with 48 points tonight. It looked like you were doing everything you could, putting up the numbers you did to try to prevent this loss. Did you feel helpless out there at times?
Nah, I know my teammates had my back, and I have theirs as well. It was frustrating not to end up on the winning side when it was all said and done, but we know that we can be better than how we played tonight. Every team's gonna go through games where not much is working, but the great teams still find ways to win in those situations, and that's where we need to improve.